New to Simplicity, first time installing a GE product? I'm Kathleen McKenna. I'm an information developer here at GE Digital, and I'm going to walk you through the process. A few important things before we get started. Simplicity is supported on several Windows operating systems, but for purposes of this video, we'll be installing a standalone Simplicity SCADA node on Windows Server 2016. For a complete list of supported operating systems, just look at the System Requirements topic in the README. Before you begin the installation process, you need to do a few things. First, log on to your computer as administrator. Confirm that you aren't logged on via RDP or terminal server. Make sure that there are no other GE products running. And finally, confirm that .NET 3.5 SP1 is installed. To check that the .NET 3.5 feature is installed, on the Add Roles and Feature Wizard, on the Features page, confirm that the option is enabled here. If not, you can enable it from this screen. To get SP1, just simply run a Windows update. Now, to install Simplicity, there are three steps. Install SQL Express, if it's not already installed. Run the Simplicity Server product install. And step three is get the latest updates from the support website and install them. Step one. Optionally, install SQL Express if you want to archive data or log alarms. Skip this step if you already have another instance of SQL installed or if you plan to use Historian to archive data and log alarms. Now, before you install SQL Express, you want to make sure that you add some rights to the local security policy for the administrative user that you're going to install SQL Server with. Under the local policy, under user rights assignment, there are three rights that we need to check that the user is included in the properties. So right here, here's a user rights assignment. And the rights are backup files and directories, debug programs, and manage auditing and security log. So these three right here. Now to install SQL Express, simply click the install link and follow the on-screen steps. There's only one screen that requires any data entry, which is this one right here. Just make sure you save the password that you enter here. The password should contain a mix of uppercase, lowercase letters, symbols, and numbers. Now step two, run the product install. This is probably the easiest it's ever been to install Simplicity. On the main install screen, click Install Simplicity Server 10 and click Next. To continue, accept the terms of the license and click Next. Select the type of Simplicity install, select Complete, and then leave the default path and click Next. Click Yes to allow Simplicity through the firewall, and then finally click the Install button. Several screens will appear during the installation process, and then the base Simplicity product will start to install. So kind of just hang out here a little bit. While we're waiting, I just want to call out some of the fantastic features of Simplicity 10, which include one of the biggest being the support for GE Digital's Web HMI product. There's been several OPC UA server enhancements to provide access to Simplicity alarms, support for Microsoft Windows Server 2016, SQL Server 2016, and GE Digital's Historian 7.0 out of bug fixes. So near the end of install, a few message boxes appear, which is what you're seeing here. Just click OK. And after this completes, reboot your computer. Step three, after you restart your computer, you may want to go up to the support website and get the latest updates. After logging into digitalsupport.ge.com, go to the Simplicity 10 product download page. So select Simplicity version 10 and downloads. And you'll see that at this point, there's not a whole lot because we just released. But it's always good to check. This concludes our product walkthrough. Thank you again for watching.